Yeah, I just...
Michelle.
I must say, I found this presentation absolutely enlightening in terms of all the knowledge that we've accumulated, and this is the third time that I listened to your presentation. But it comes to my mind that what we're dealing with, and without getting into conspiratorial assumptions, is a very complex decision-making process. If we're talking about the architects of this project, because we have the intellectual architects, okay, people who are thinking, who are reflecting on the art of catastrophes. Maybe Zelikow would belong to that category. Then there are the economic, political, intelligence actors. Then there are the scientific engineering architects of how you put this thing together, okay? And then there are the people who actually implement it in technical terms, that go and place the bombs and so on and ultimately supervise the bringing down of the buildings. But then you have another problem. You have the cover-up aspects. You have to cover up at the scientific technological level, which is a very expensive operation. I mean, your report is probably worth at least 10 times that of the NIST, okay, which would make it a $200 million report. But so you have the cover-up, and then you have the technical scientific cover-up, and then you have also the media political cover-up at all levels, and building a consensus and propaganda. Then you have the follow-up actions that people that decision makers will use this event for the so-called GWAT, Global War on Terrorism, which has been my area of investigation. But then you have to protect against the leaks of witnesses, count 9/11 truth people, etc., etc., to make sure that ultimately the story sticks. And at that stage, we move into something which is equivalent to the Spanish Inquisition. But then the question is, how many people, but you have to make sure that nobody talks, okay, within these, how many people are involved in this whole process, okay? I would say thousands of people. And how many of these people might at one point in time say the truth and spill the beans? That is the question. How is this consensus ultimate? It's a very fragile consensus because it's based on a big lie. But it's also based on an inquisitorial doctrine where the lie becomes the truth. And everything that we say here is of course a pack of lies, as portrayed in the mainstream media. But my question, I know that we're going beyond the bounds of this debate tonight, but you mentioned how many people are involved. I think that is a very important question. And where are they? And will they talk?
Great question. We don't know that some of them haven't come forward. We wouldn't know if they did, because the media is not covering the issue anyway. We've been screaming at the media for 6 years, others for 10 years. How many of you knew about 9/11? It was super fishy, if you will, from day one. See, look around the room. I feel pretty dense when I'm around people like this, because they got it, like, on day one. And they didn't have architects and engineers helping them for 4 or 5 years, you know. So I applaud you guys, especially those of you who were trying to convince other people about the elephant in the room. It would take hundreds of people involved in this. We talked about the Manhattan Project, where 100,000 people were involved and were able to keep it a secret. So I don't have a great answer as to how you control them. Certainly you separate them. These are categorized operations with a need-to-know basis in different compartments of such operations. That's one obvious tool that's used to keep information from getting out. They all have taken oath, right? I mean, those who are government employees, those who are not are probably certainly under some sort of threat of death if they open their mouths. We don't know how many of them are still alive, as a matter of fact, people who place these explosives. So that's the best we can do. I'm an architect, not a planner of covert operations. So I don't know. But I think the questions are important enough that we should all be wrestling with them, but not let it obscure the reality of the simple set of self-corroborating evidence that we've described tonight. It is not invalidated by anybody's incredulity about how this could have been pulled off. It is not invalidated by your inability to imagine this level of evil, if you will. Okay? They're not like us, the people who did this. They have a whole different strategy, a whole different level of control and planning and thinking that obviously is beyond our imagination, except those of us who have been, those of you who have been researching this for sometimes decades and exposing the manipulations that 9/11 is only one part of. There are rabbit holes you can crawl down and they interconnect, and you'll find out a lot more information once you step into the rabbit hole of 9/11, which was my first rabbit hole. You find a whole lot more has been going on this planet that we don't know about or haven't known about. The internet is a great source of information and of awareness for us to realize that this kind of stuff's been going on a long time, and it'll get worse if we don't stop it.